After that last capture, I don't know.
I
You
am
gotta
not
leave the
gonna do
line in the
anything
water.
more funny.
You're not gonna do anything
I'm
that
not
funny?
gonna be funny!
No, it's not.
It is your
It's
fault.
not my fault you don't know how to use a knife.
No, it's entirely your fault.
No. There's like three.
Entirely your fault.
You were cleaning up here, like with the knife blade facing your head. Oh my god. You're like making these big swooping movements.
Megan?
Does that help when you sniffle?
It's pure stew.
Do it again. We finally found your power.
Wait a second.
Ah.
You mean that
all this
you've
time?
You've known me for all this time and you didn't think I had a power?
Oh, I did, but now you know what it is.
So,
yeah.
For all these years, for like fucking 19 years, you haven't seen a power from me as if I've been handicapped all this time. Is that what you're trying to say?
Nope.
Hey guys, I'm Seaweed, and this is my gorgeous husband, Jesse.
Hi!
And we're Tribal Seed Project. Welcome to another episode of Fair Antics.
What's Fair Antics, honey?
It's simple fare for simple folk.
That's us.
Except that we're really not very simple.
There's like a little twist to it, isn't there?
There is. There's a complete little twist to it. What are we going to be making today, Jesse?
Today, we are going to be making a traditional favorite. We're going to have pork chops.
Mmm.
Healthier and lose some weight. And
can
we
start over? Sure.
See something funny?
Get off me!
Face the camera.
Get off me! You move, Daisy! Stick him! Okay, Daisy, sit. Sit.
Good voodoo.
Your mom's an oodoo. She's a doo-doo-oodoo.
With both of them. And to start those off, we're going to put a little olive oil in both pans just to help them out a little bit. And we'll cut open our frozen broccoli. I like to cook the broccoli with the lid on it because it makes it cook better. And we'll put that on a medium heat. Then we're going to go ahead and get our pork chop started. These are bone-in pork chops. Some center cuts. And we're going to go ahead and just give it a little seasoning. And while we're going to season that, before we do that, we're going to put some garlic in our pan and start warming our pan up. that in a little bit so that the whole pan is nice and evenly coated. And for our pork chops themselves, we're going to go ahead and put some, just a little sprinkle of onion powder and a little adobo. Mrs. Dash. And we're going to go ahead and just lay them right in the pan. And we'll lay them with the herbicide down so that we can then season the other side. And again, a simple little bit on each side. Go ahead and let that cook.
Excuse me, sir.
There ain't no room at the inn.
Excuse me, sir. We help a little old lady to cross the street.
You're in a house.
I am?
Look at T.T.
Elliot.
So now what we're going to do is we're going to add our artichokes and we're going to add our peppers. You get the regular ones in the glass. They come with oil. I've already dumped out the oil. You put them on your cutting board. Again, it depends on how you like your artichokes. Some people like them in big chunks. We like ours in smaller pieces. And again, we're just going to chop these up a couple of times each way. The artichokes make a nice little addition to the protein. And there again, it's totally acceptable for your carb diet. Now we're going to go ahead and just empty this right into the pork chops. Now we're going to go ahead and do our red pepper addition to the broccoli to give it some color. And again, you're going to chop this up in very similar fashion as you did with the artichokes. It adds a little bit more flavor to the vegetable, and at the same time it gives it a nice color to kind of offset the green. Because on a no-carb diet, you can have a lot of greens, and after a while you're looking for something more than just something green. Now we're going to go ahead and add this to our broccoli. Being that these are cooking really good, we're going to give it a stir. Get some stuff mixed in there. Now's a good time to add any of the seasoning that you would add to your vegetable. We're going to go ahead and flip over our pork chops so that we can cook on the other side. Mix our broccoli up one more time to get all those together. Now Now you're going to want to mix your broccoli every so often until it cooks down to where it's soft. You can tell with a fork when it's done. On the pork chops, a couple of different ways you can go about it. If you have a thermometer, a meat thermometer, you can go ahead and stick it in there and it should be about 160 degrees internally. Or for us regular folks, sometimes we just like to cut into the middle and see if it's pink or not. That's your best way to do that. And again, you're going to want to turn this every so often. Depending upon you getting your flavoring, you may want to add more seasoning to it or not. That's entirely up to you.
Okay, fine.
Good.
You'll be good too.
Yeah.
Look, I must think I'm drinking tea. Now. I don't have a neck. Where's my neck?
I don't want to use shortcomings.
You're not very funny. You make me so sad. So sad!
Dinner of pork chops topped with artichoke hearts and garlic and a side of broccoli and red peppers.
Wow, that looks really good. You are. That looks great. Very beautiful.
Another beautiful no carb.
Thanks for watching tonight, guys. We hope that you learned something from this and also enjoyed watching as well. We would love to hear what you have to say, so please leave a comment below. If you liked the video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Check out our website and some of the other cool stuff we got going out there. And until next time, guys, happy cooking and happy living. Bye.
See you.